ETC very much welcomes the news that Euro NCAP will amend its protocols and for 2018 will also include AEB for cyclists. In today's congested and polluted cities, cycling is become a very important mode of transport. We shouldn't forget that cycling is cheap, cycling is affordable, and cycling is also environmentally friendly. But we need to make sure that cycling is also safe. We need to encourage people to be on the bike, but we need to make sure that they know they can be safe by doing this.
The Euro NCAP 5-star rating includes all the critical safety technology that is on the market today. So whether it's technology that helps people get less injured or not injured inside a crash, adults or children, whether it's technology that helps avoid crashes with vulnerable road users such as pedestrians, or is it new technology, such as camera-based or radar-based technology that assists the driver in avoiding a crash in the first place? So all these technologies are important components of the 5-star rating of Euro NCAP. Now, these technologies do not stay the same forever. They actually evolve year in, year out. New cars come onto the market with new technology, and Euro NCAP is always looking how this technology works, develops new tests and includes this in the rating system. And that's why the rating system is evolving over time. And this year in 2018, we have included again many new aspects of safety in our star rating system, but the most important one is cyclist detection technology.
So AEB means autonomous emergency braking, and it's a collision avoidance system. And it is a technology that uses sensors to detect the presence of cyclists. And when the system can see a cyclist, it will automatically brake. And the system usually uses camera and radar sensors.
Euro NCAP started to look at accident rate from public roads with the objective of identifying which are the most critical situations involving passenger cars and cyclists. And then we derived test scenarios representing those collisions to be reproduced on the test track. For that, you need a target cyclist, which is representing a real cyclist, and it's put in front of a car with the objective of evaluating whether the car is able to avoid a collision with the cyclist or mitigate the consequences.
European Cyclist Federation, we welcome very much that Euro NCAP is involving now the protection of cyclists in their technology systems. And the autonomous emergency braking is very important as part of a system approach to protect cyclists.